That's a good fish, dude. If that's a crappie, seriously? No, this is good, good. If it's a crappie, it is too. Oh boy. Wow, man. Come on. Just stay, 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 stay. Oh my goodness me. If someone says plates, put out the dinner plate. I might call this one dinner plate crappie. Why? Look at that, man. Content for what's about to arrive here in the Northern Lakes, and that is spring. Ice comes off, it's time for those big, beautiful black crappie to get hungry and get interested in getting caught. So I got a couple scenarios that I want to share with you that I've done over the years with a few buddies, Josh McKay, Joe Taylor, some different guys down south as well that I fish with in the spring, but this is more about the Northern Lakes. When the ice first comes off, the water temperatures are just freezing cold in the 40s to low 50s, mid 50s, and the different scenarios that we've been faced with on how to find crappie, how to catch crappie, what to use, and where to fish on the lakes. Do you go shallow? Do you go deep? Do you go thick? Do you go to weeds? Do you go to wood? What do you do? There's different scenarios we have that we're going to share with you on this YouTube special, catching a big slab crappie in really cold water. Now, the first thing I want to say is, don't be misled about waiting for that 50 degree, 52 to 54, 56, thinking that I have to wait for those fish to get shallow. I'm gonna tell you honestly, there is a scenario when the ice first comes off, it's a phenomena. Some of the biggest females in Ontario lakes head shallow. I don't know what it is, that little influx, a little bit of warmer water inspires them, who knows what they're thinking. Maybe they're just excited to get up and meet some males and stuff. Who knows? But what we do know is my buddy Joe Taylor and I had some phenomenal first ice out times catching big black crappie on the Kawartha Lake system up in Northern Ontario near Peterborough, Bob Cage and those areas. Just simply amazing. Then a cold front hits, they pull out again. But again, you just gotta follow the fish. On this first scenario, I'm fishing with Joe and it's one of our first trips, okay, of the year. A week before, we had ice come off, water temperatures and the temperatures in those areas skyrocketed, and guys that we met up in the body of water that we were fishing, same week before, they had 200 fish days in the same areas we were fishing. We had to scratch and scrape, catch some fish, but I'll show you how we did it so you can do it. When the water temperatures on the main lake are in the low 40s, and you gotta find those temperatures in the back that are between 52, 53, 54. For some fish to come in, thinking about what they want to do when the water temperatures rise a little bit more, but that magic 52, 53, 54 was good on these lakes right here. Cold front crappie in spring. I'm going to show you how I fish them with the slip bobber and little shad bait. We're going to pick a little back bait. That's the warmest water we can find. In springtime, those crappies get right in that stuff here up in Ontario, Texas, and Oklahoma and stuff. There's different areas, different ways they fish for them, single poling. You know, they still use a float, but it's a very popular technique and presentation to catch them. We set it up with a slip float here, and you got a little bobber stop that you put on, so it affects how far up the float will go up, then that affects how deep you're fishing. So that there is about 24 inches, okay? The area I'm gonna be fishing is about 4.5, between 3 to about 5 feet, I'd say. So about 4.5 feet. So I'm gonna start with the float, a little deeper, about 36 inches. And I'm vary that depending on the bites, the depth I'm at. I always wanna keep this little bait above the crappie's face so he sees it. I don't like to have to make them go down. They will eat down, but I like to have them just look up and go and grab it. Little shad baits I'm gonna use, just look like real small little profile. 1/16 ounce jig heads, little shad bait with the hook protrude, okay? Some different colors that I'm gonna use is the bright chartreuse, pink with black, the pink head, okay? So I just have them ready just in case. And then same thing, slip bobber, this time with chartreuse, a little bit of black, chartreuse head, all 1/16 ounce. And I got them on various 7'6" and 7-foot B&M Crappie Wizards and Sam Super Sensitive with the slip float, little reels. We're gonna catch some crappie. Yep.
Oh my God, dude. Whoa, look at, he's still another one. Wow, black and gold, dude.
Oh yeah, that's
good. Oh, the one I just missed, my first crappie of the year, was a tank. It looked like a giant crappie. Look at the little lips, little plastic. First little one of the year. First trip of the year. Cold front, like, I mean, it was 70 degrees yesterday. Today, it's like 40. But anyhow, we'll let them go. Let me show you how it's gonna be. Plastics and little bobbers in a little back bay. My favorite poles, favorite spot, and favorite species in spring, black crappies. How can you beat it? Man, the first one I seen turn, it all was all gold, all the bottom. And as soon as it settled, it went to the right already. Like a kid again fishing. That's what crappies do. There's one. Oh boy, what are you? Oh, it's crappie. Man, little males, huh? Good eating size fish. Boy, oh boy. 10, 11 inch. Look at that. Just gorgeous little fish. Let them go. You want to find one of those big mamas. Let's just keep going. Let's try to find a big mama. And I know what you're thinking. Oh yeah, sure, the first one he lost was a giant. But I saw the whole turn. It looked like a plate. But that's how it goes. Just having fun. There's another one. Ay, ay, ay. Man, oh man. Here's the deal. Lighter rod. This rod I got, it's a 7'6". How long that is? So I make those easy underhand pitches. Because I got only 1/16 ounce little jig. Small little plastic bait. Little shad bait. Bright chartreuse with white. And I see how I got that slip bobber. And it's about, oh, I'd say 30 inches probably from where the bait goes. So it slides up. And I put an extra little split shot on here just so the bait gets down faster. It doesn't take time. Get right back down where they are. So the bobber will sit straight. A lot of times crappie eat, when they hit upwards, the float goes this way. So I want that float not to be sitting like this. You know, it might miss that. But when it's totally vertical like this and they come up and eat it, the float will go boom. As soon as it sits sideways, set hook. So let's try it. We're in the right spot. Let's catch some crappie. Okay, it's first week of May. Water temperatures back here are like 54 degrees. On the main lake, 42, 43. So it's imperative in this little back bays with black bottom, silty old leaves and branches and wood and stuff, it heats up faster. So 42 degrees out in the main lake, 43. Back in here, 54, 56. And I think that by the time the afternoon comes, 1, 2 o'clock, when the sun stays high, it's away from the wind, it gets up to around 57, 58, they're going to be on fire. That's a good fish, dude. If that's a crappie, seriously? No, this is good, good. If it's a crappie, it is too. Oh, boy. Wow, man. Come on. Just stay, 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 stay. Oh, my goodness me. Someone says plates. Put out the dinner plate. I might call this one dinner plate crappie. Why? Look at that, man. Look at that. I know you get those giants in Mississippi and Oklahoma and Texas, but that's what we catch right here in Ontario. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous fish? We take some pictures of some fish and maybe have a meal, but right there, that's what I'm looking for. Let's put her in here, huh? Go in here, right, girl? For a swim. Plastics, bobbers, and fun. Sit back up, get some more. What's really important is you have enough weight, like a little split shot here, 1/16 ounce jig head. So that sometimes it's not enough weight to make that float sit totally vertical. Crappie fishing, it's so important to have your float vertical, because a lot of times they'll come up, boop, when it goes flat like that, set hook, because nothing else does it other than a crappie. So he comes up to it, sees it, inhales it, boop, float goes sideways, you set. But make sure you have enough weight that the water level is about halfway, three quarters away, so all you see is a little bit of orange on top of the water. It's very sensitive to pull under, so they don't feel any resistance. But when it's totally vertical like that, a crappie bites, it just goes under nice and slow, that's easy to see. But sometimes they hit it, it goes this way, set hook. Wow. There's a good one right there, dude. Uh-oh. I think that's... Come on, splash. Now she's splashing. Oh, boy. Hey. Wow, do I ever... love crappie. Oh man, look at that. Look at that. Watch this. Ready? See where that hook is? Look at that membrane, man. How they just slice it. And those real big ones come off like that. Again, that's just a good eater, but I might catch a few, take home for dinner, have a small meal, but I'm looking for the big ones. And it's so hard to beat springtime with a bobber before they get real tight. When they get real tight, I like to hunt. Pick up that long pole, individual fish, clumps, trees, bushes, rocks, and stuff like that. But it's so hard to beat a little plastic bait, small jig head, sliding bobber along the shallows and clumps, catch them in spring. You see it works, man, and it's very popular. Let's catch another one. Right up, you can stay back, and you can suspend the bait right in the fish's face, and they can't resist it. You twitch it, let it stop. They come up. Get that little bait. See a little tail on it? So when I'm casting out working areas, I don't let it sit for a long time. These fish will tell you real quick if they're there. Cast, let it settle, floats its vertical, twitch, and down. What's happening is every time you twitch, that little bait goes up and down, up, down. That little tail. See what happens when I move it? It shakes. When it shakes, that's when they eat it. We're catching fish right there. Pulls down. Are you crappie or are you gill? Big crappie. Oh boy. Wow, man. A little shad bait. I changed it up to a little chartreuse or orange with chartreuse. Nice little slab. Whoa, man, that's a nice looking fish. That's the ones right there. That's the ones right there. Keep mama happy. Easy fillet. Tell me that's not fun, eh? Seeing that little float just twitch, boom. So I caught some different species, caught some pike, and all of a sudden, the crappies decide to wake up. And that's the thing with crappie fishing. You get one going, it's like the whole school decides, hey man, there's minnows here, let's eat them. So be patient, keep moving around, stay on the trolling motor, look down the sonar, watch your depths and stuff. Remember where you caught the first fish, 3 to 5 feet of water, and keep replicating that in the same areas you are, and you'll keep catching them just like this. I let it sit, and then I twitch. Just get their attention. Maybe you'll come over and just inhale it. Come on, boys. One or two more here? You know there is. But maybe they move this way, that way. Maybe they're in the channel now. Ooh, boy. That is black crappie. You see that? Out a bit further. Oh, nice one too. Oh, wow. Wow. Bobbers and shad baits. Wow. Right in the hard part where it's like, you know, he's coming in the boat. Wow. Or on what you're watching now, YouTube. But I got a few like that in a box. So you go back, go on. No, you can't believe it. He's like, what happened? What happened? Okay, I put one right by the front where I was catching. Let's see. Any more there? Uh-oh. Can I pull another one out of here? many got stung mouths? How many went back? Yep. Whoa. Oh boy. Walter was in there. Look at on the outside edge, man. Oh, eating the soft shad bait. Look at that. Is that a handful or what? Wow. Tell me that isn't fawn crappies, man. Right past the membrane. That's why I use those jig heads that are a little bit more set back. I'll take a few pictures of that one. We'll let her go. But man, oh man. Got the poles down. Casting to it. I pulled her off there. Or him off. Let's see. No. Look at the skinny little belly. That's a male. That's a male. Let's see if I can get another one to come out. Fix up my bait. So, staying upwind and let it drift by right on there. And I mean, when I'm hooking these fish, they feel heavy because they're right in the brush. And they just come out again. So it's important to pull them off that stuff before they go back in. Let's see if there's another one in there. Right off the tip of it, right there. Whew! It's another one? Is it a big one? Couldn't resist that little shad going by like a minnow, huh? A little nose sticking out. Come on, boy. There's always one more, isn't there? Put it right in front and see if I can drift it in front of the brush without getting stuck. Right there. Let it drift inside it. Look at that. Come on, puppy. Come on out. Come on out. Look at that. It's dangerous, isn't it? Yeah, man. Danger. Danger, Will Robbins. Ooh. Like I said, slippery slope. Got to get it right on the spot without getting inside there. But it was a decent fish in there. Let that tree load up again. Another day. Let's put one right back in here. I really believe I got to be real tight to it. Before I can get bit, but let's see. And he's sitting on the outside. Yep. Uh-oh. Wow, hey. Just a fun crappie. You see, I thought it was black crappie. It's a fun crappie. Look at that. Beautiful looking fish. That's good eating, man, no matter where you fish right there. Good eating. Thick back, big mouth. Let's let him go. Go on. It is, well, there you have it. An afternoon of slip bobbers and small little plastic baits. Catching crappies like there's no tomorrow in a few little pods. Some jack of all trades, one here, one there. We found a little pocket of fish, caught some fish, had some fun. Think of the plastics, think of the bobbers, think of crappie.
See what I mean? Those bigger fish sitting out in the back, had to scrap and scrape and try to find some fish. A little bit here, a little bit there. Still good enough for our first feed of the year, so it's pretty good. On this next segment, I'm gonna show you another scenario, another early spring during high water. Ice cold, man, dirty, flooded areas. But I decided I'm gonna start picking up that single pole. So I worked my way into a little trailer park area, little sloughs and things in the back bay of a big lake, looking for those crappie with the float. Caught one or two with the float right away, found some down trees and bushes and stuff, and man, it was on big time. But the thing is, I didn't have to go to little baits. I used these things right here. You know what that is, right? Right there. Orange chartreuse and a Sardis gold that I called gold dust. Something about using a bigger bait, and that is the crappie magnet, slab magnet. Don't think just because it's spring, the bait fish are small, that the crappie want to eat small. You want to catch bigger crappie, think about a little bit bigger profile with that little tail that just shakes. You want to still fish slow. You might have to hold that bait a lot longer in those spots in the tree, wherever it is, but you alter your approach, whether they're in shallow pads, whether they're in fallen trees, they're in wood or rock. Crappie can surprise you, those early season ones. When they gang up in those spots, you would not even know they're there if you fish too fast. You pick up that big single pole, 10 foot, 11 foot, 12 foot, whatever the B&M you like. I like the SAM Super Sensitive, the Ultralight, the Tree Thumper, but just pick it up, man. If you haven't done single poling for crappie, you have no idea what you're missing. But in the scenario you're gonna see next, you're gonna have a good idea what you're missing. So pick up that single pole and catch them.
Even this trailer park, man, has muddy, muddy water. I mean, it is wicked. This time on the Xtreme Crappie Angler, it's bright chartreuse, chartreuse orange, chartreuse pink, bright baits, looking for crappies in spring, in cold water, on a perfect sunny day, in heavy cover. Maybe I'll even use a float and stuff, but it's about finding them, putting the power poles down, taking my time, and potentially catching some nice big fish after a long winter for the family and have some fun. But it's finding them, using the right baits, right positioning, and hopefully catching crappies. Let's get right up real tight like this, then I'll put the poles down right there. Hold me in position. There, they're in the right spot. Let's see if they're right here. We know this tree in the past has held fish. Slow. Oh, I missed one right there. Wow, did you pull my skirt down? Nope, I missed one right there. Wow, it's so cool. Pull up to the tree, drop down, and I just hold it sometimes. Barely shake my wrist, man. They will tell you they're there. Oh boy, that water's cold. Just still get them to eat. See the puffs in there, that's from my trolling motor. Wow, it's a lot of sand and mud in the water. And this is going to be the deal right here, fishing little trees and bushes, bright colored baits for crappie. I'm holding that thing down about 4 inches below the surface, and it's so bright, obnoxious color. Like, look at this thing right here, so bright and obnoxious. Bright chartreuse head, chartreuse little tail, gold body. Like, it's something that, man, you want the brightest, most obnoxious things on a day like this when you're fishing water that's from floods, rains, and it's murky. I'm gonna call it just dirty. You can't even see the fish. You just gotta have faith that you're putting in the right spots. Look at that. Hey, the slab magnet dudes, and then you slip them. That's a pig too, look at that. That's how we start our morning, in dirty water with the slab magnet, boys and girls. Look at that. I'm gonna show you, come right back and show you where he is. Look at that. You think he inhaled that? You know he wanted it. Right there, look at that. That's the double cross jig head, 1/16 ounce, with the gold sparkle. Look at it, chartreuse, and that's what it catches right there. Beautiful, Eaton-sized crappie. Gonna put a few in the box, a few for pictures, but boy, I tell you, when you start out first thing, picking up your P&M 12-footer, SAM Super Sensitive, and the first drop is that, you know it's gonna be a good day. Let me show you what I'm doing. So you can do it. Right there, a crappie magnet, the slab magnet. And it's a thicker profile, like a shad bait, right? Okay, flat top, little flat tail. And look at that, you barely gotta move your arm. Showed you in the water that I barely shake my wrist. Get that tail just a kick. And I got it in the B&M, SAM Super Sensitive jig pole, 12-footer, two-piece. with the setback reel seat, a small little reel. You know what? That's not even a reel. It just holds the line. That's all I want. So I'm pulling up line out, and you know the deal that when I'm fishing with this 12 footer, and I got, well, I'd say almost 12, 13 feet coming down, that gives me 25 plus feet of range. I put the power poles down, find a tree, find a dock, find the fish first with the Garmin, and then just dissect and crush. Let me get back at it, and I'll show you, hopefully, why you should consider bright, bright colors like this in muddy, dirty water. Now, you say to yourself, it's not real muddy and stuff. I know it's not Mississippi, you know, red clay mud, but this still is muddy. I can't see down 4 inches, but I want these things to see that bright gold and chartreuse with the chartreuse double cross head, and we're gonna catch them. Altering my depth, I have to keep it up high. Most of these fish are eating, they still come up and they'll swirl at it and eat it. Where are you, big crappies? Where are you, big crappies? I fished the whole tree, man. Dissect every inch. Fifty-two degrees. Wow. Bit of work here. So you say, why the 12-foot pole? Maybe get away with a 10-footer. With a 10-footer, I'm closer to those fish. I don't want them to see me. Even in the dirty water, even in the bush and stuff, I want to stay back. 12 feet with 12 feet of line, that gives me 24 feet of pendulum to stay back, arm out, drop it down, swim it, move it all around. And in that case, fishing in these bushes and stuff, and not very wide, that little cut, I keep the boat back further so I don't have to worry about pulling the rod back, hitting the trees, hitting the branches and stuff. I just keep moving around. With a 12 footer, you can extend your arm, get another 3 feet. It's just so much versatility with a 12 footer. It's my jig pole of choice. Look at that, hey? That is what I'm fishing for, dudes. Ready? Here comes the big swing. He's big and he's bad. He's big and he's bad. I thought, I don't know if you're the same one I just seen, boy. Whoa, look at that. Whoa, he's got major attitude, but just a beautiful fish, man. I'm gonna put you in. You are gonna taste so good. First crappie feed of the year. First crappie feed of the year. Catching big, beautiful slabs, boy. Golden black. Look at it. Golden black. Hey? Oh, yeah. You know what? For me, it's all about hunting them down, boys. Let's put him in there. Look at that. I only got 6 crappie. 6 crappie. How many crappie do you need for a meal? You know, me and my wife, so that's 12 fillets. How many do you need? Respect the fishery, and it will reward you with keep catching them. I'm gonna try a few more trees, a few more docks, and then I'm gonna say, that's it for the muddy, cold water day of crappie slamming. Man, oh man, something about when you find crappie, they're not hard to catch. But it's just having the patience and the fortitude and the stubbornicity, I call it, of finding them. Because once you find them, it's incredible. Put the poles down, anchor down, and just wait. Single pole and going around, getting their attention, bringing it up, shake it, round, swim it, stop it. And it's just like they come out of the tree, they look, roll on it. But they don't come flying at it. They just slowly come up. You don't see them in that dirty water. You just see that last flash, or all you see is this little bait disappear. Right there, that's what it looks like in the package. Slab magnet, it's called Blake's Glow, okay? Look at that, it just glows. But in the dark, dirty water, especially in cold water like that, I want them to see it, you know? And a lot of times when I'm lifting that bait up and stuff, I see them inhale it, but I want them to see it. In murky water, mud, flood conditions and stuff, water goes down, those fish have a tough time seeing it. You see even those big eyes the crappies have. So the better they can actually see something and focus in on it, the better attention or opportunities for you to catch them. Another one right here is a chartreuse ice. So to get them, bright chartreuse, it's got some silver flake in it, but the bait of the day was right there. Gold dust. I might call it Goldberg. Right there, because it just knocks them out. Another option, obviously, it's like what they use in Mississippi, in real dark water that has the red mud, is the orange with chartreuse tail. But you see the common denominator? Chartreuse. Just something about in that dirty water. I'll use it in clear water too, but something about that dirty water, they can just zone in on it, you know, all of a sudden, something about it. So you have different colors, different options, but stick with the things that have chartreuse, glow, and obviously the brand new gold flake. I'm about 3 inches below the surface. Look at that. Zigzagging around. Good one too. Wow, hey. Oh yeah, he's a good one. He's a good one. He's a good one. Look how he got it. That's why I use those double cross hooks. Look at that. Watch that. Done. Wow, man. Nice crappie. Look at that. He got attacked. Look. His scales got away from some pike or something. Wow. Let's put him in there. We ain't taking a lot of fish. We only got 4 in the live well. But here's exactly how I do this. I come into different areas when I'm fishing for dirty water crappies. And I got my slip float with my little crappie magnet, okay? Again, double cross. This is 1/16 ounce jig head, bright chartreuse, and orange chartreuse, okay? They made this orange years ago, Mississippi, with this real dark colors, you know, Arkansas, different places where, you know, they got that red mud. So when that mud goes in the water and they got floods and stuff, that water is like seriously like chocolate milk. So they made a color that can offset that. So the orange with the chartreuse and stuff, so you can keep fishing. You don't have to find an excuse why not to go fishing. So I use this as a locator, okay? So I work my way into areas, through it. I keep adjusting the depth, back and forth, trying to find it. And this, I got it on the 7-foot SAM Super Sensitive B&M, little B&M reel, 6-pound copolymer, a gamma. So that helps me look around and find fish before I actually spot where I want to fish with a single pool. And I got 2 options at these. Number one is the SAM Super Sensitive 12-foot with the slab magnet, with the gold dust and the chartreuse. And let me show you the other one. So I have a 1-2 combination, okay? Gotta be prepared. You don't need to have tons of rods. This one is the B&M Ultralight, 12-foot, little rear reel seat at the back here. This just holds line for me. And look at that again. This one has got 1/8 ounce jig head with the slab magnet, bright orange with chartreuse. That's the deal. 6-pound test, keep things real simple. But I am prepared for when I find them, when I scout for them. So when the water is muddy, cold and stuff, you have options. Don't find excuses, go crappie fishing, but be ready, be versatile, and you're gonna catch them. It's so exciting. You can tell by my heartbeat, the adrenaline, you know, the speech. But I mean, when you're just doing that, you go, it's a sense of accomplishment, figuring it out and finding them. But like I said before, I'll say it again, there's so many different tools, from the motor guide at the front, the Garmin helping me find the water temperature, where it's warmer, and these little cuts and canals closer to the shorelines and things, and the shorelines just didn't have it. Nice wood and brush and stuff, no fish. They wanted those little cuts and stuff, but the water went up to about 54 degrees. But the little slab magnet on the 12 footer, you got the whole chain. I'm constantly checking the hook points all the time. The gauge, when you set hook, it opens up the little fine wire hook once in a while. You just push it back down again with the pliers, checking that line that goes down. Those fish are rubbing against branches and brush and stuff, and you're fishing some nasty things. But putting all those little pieces together in the chain, and what's the result? Catching those big fat slabs.
What did I tell you about single pole and big slab crappie, eh? When they see that slab magnet put in their face and held there, they just have to eat it. On this next segment in early spring, another early season trip, it was late April, water temperatures, we fished everywhere, man, we couldn't find any consistency of the mid-50s and stuff. So instead of just looking for those back sloughs like we did a couple trips before, years before as well, went to like history water, wasn't producing. We looked for main lake stuff that was sheltered, that we all know you can catch crappie through the ice. You all do it, okay? And you know when they gang up, what are you looking for? Weeds. Try to find the first thick green weeds. And on some lakes in Northern Ontario, Quebec, no matter where you fish, in the north country of the States, there's gonna be that high weed that lives all winter. We found some and we fished it slow with the float, little crappie magnet, paste it, set ourselves up, work the weed bed all through it, alter the slip floats back and forth at depth. Took a little trial and error, and I'll be honest, took almost 2 hours on a couple different weed beds to find those crappie. But when I found them, it was lights out again. One after another, all different sizes, got another good feed, but sometimes it's more about figuring it out than actually catching those big giant slabs. Because hey, it was a long winter, wanted to catch crappie, caught crappie, but had to find the thick green weed, fish it slow, fish it methodically, and make it work for me, because I guarantee you it'll work for you. Looking for some green grass. There's some green grass right there, 9 feet. Come on, dude. Let me fluke upon a school of big, fat, golden slabs. Stupid as hell. You know what those look like. Oh boy, dude, this is a major weed bed, Kent. Major. Holy moly. Wow. Yeah, 10 feet deep and the weed's like 3-4 feet deep. There's weed and there's life down here. Don't know sure what kind of life. Nice if it's crappy life. Look at that, eh? Crappie on the weed bed in cold, ugly conditions. Ugly, the fish are freezing cold, but crappie magnet does it again. Hey, first crappie of the year. I know you're saying, come on, Carl, but it's first crappie of the year. I'm a happy man. Sometimes it's search and destroy. This morning has been search, search, search. And one so far, but you know, the never give up. You've heard it before. That's what I'm doing right here and now. So put one in the box. We're going to call them out. He's maybe 11 inches long, but he's the first cold water crappie of the year, late April in Northern Ontario. Let's put him in the well, show you how I'm doing it. So you can do it and you can catch him and you can have fun too. By slowly searching and destroying when the water's not even 50 degrees. Let's get back out, throw the float, try to catch some more crappie. Let's go. Here's the biggest thing I'm gonna show you. I'm fishing over 10 feet of water and the weed comes up 5 feet. So right here, I've got the float, okay? The little bobber stop is here and the bait's down there. So I've got it about 5.5 feet deep, okay? What I'm gonna do, because cold conditions and the wind and stuff, these fish are just really slow, make it even deeper. So as the float goes down, I got a split shot, so stop it, help it go down faster. That little crappie magnet is almost just pulling through that milfoil, the deep weed, going and bouncing above it. And because there's a little bit of wind, so it's not straight down like this, okay? It's a little bit of an angle. So I'm not really fishing the depth that I have the bobber stop, okay? It's that angle, the pendulum. If I want to get right into the weeds, I've got a 1/16 ounce little jig head there. I'll go to maybe 1/8, 5/32. It's about getting that bait right through where they are. They're not really aggressive. The water's cold. There's hardly any sun. They're sitting right up amongst that weed,
right near the tips of it. So that bait's got to go right through their nose, right by like this, before they decide to. So you got to put that bait right where they are, adjust the float back and forth until they tell you where they are, then you'll catch them. You know what that is right there, right? Slab bite. A little bit of taste. When it's really cold, that's what it looks like right there. Crappie magnet, slab bite. It's not an ad. These things actually catch, and they're good too because they're really smelly and stuff. And some of the competitor stuff is good too. It's scented, but you catch one fish and it falls off. This one hasn't fallen off. They perfected the texture, the scent, the smell, and it definitely helps you when crappie are in cold water conditions. They don't want to eat. Great for ice fishing, but right now I put that on and I got bit. Not a scientist, crappie fisherman. See if we can get some more. See that? You saw that. Big gill. Oh, nice crappie. Nice crappie. That's what you want right there. Now we're getting a bit more respectable. See that? Whoa! Maybe later we'll actually be able to put on that fish fry and put up our dual basket deep fryer and have some first crappie of the year. They're not giants at all. We're hoping to get some big ones, but that's ones I like to eat too. I can get some nice fillets off there. You know, those big ones are fantastic for pictures and see them flopping on the surface and stuff, but you know, I respect this fishery, man. Let those big females go, produce more of those ones, the ones to eat. But in the deep south, think about that, man. These are the ones right there that feed a lot of families right there. Black crappie, white crappie, that's the size right there. 11 inch, perfect size for eating. I am gonna kiss you because I'm gonna have you and enjoy you later. Marker boys there, see where the fish are. On the spot, see if we can catch some more. The sun might inspire them. Oh boy, uh-oh. I think Carl got a better crappie. Yep, better crappie. Yes, yes, yes. Well, I'm gonna show you how these things eat, man. I'll tell you why people love catching crappies. Look at that. Look at that. Down the yap, dude. I've got that thing just perfect now. I'll show you what I mean in a second here. Let me put him in the box, okay? I'll show you what I mean about adjusting floats. Here's the deal. When I first came in, had the first bite, I was about 5 feet down, okay? So now here's the bobber stop right here. There's at the bottom. So yeah, it's about 5+. And I adjusted it back and forth, 4, 6 sometimes. I was touching the weed, 4. I got a couple small fish. Right now I got it just about perfect. So let's see. There's the bottom. Here's the top. About 5+. That's the deal. And I've got the marker boy there. And I'm putting it right over the weeds that are 10 feet deep. The weed comes up to about 6 feet. So you know it's going right over the top of the weed, right where they're sitting. Traditional jig, yeah, nice and sharp, you know, 1/8 ounce white. But the keeper is just like the standard ones you find on a lot of jigs. These Northern Tackle Supply ones, if you see the comparison, it has a keeper at the back end, like a real little pin. Fantastic. And then sharp, further back, setback hook. I totally believe when I'm fishing with crappie baits and stuff, I want that hook point and the curve as far back in the bait as possible for those ones that just nip at it. Then you get them up on the top, okay? The shorter shank hook sometimes, you miss those when the bait's a bit longer. So I got 1/8 ounce in a white. It's been catching some fish with me. Let me show you a couple other options these guys have. Okay, so I'm using the white right here, and you can tell I don't play around. These are with the Mustad, nice solid shank. You know, if I ever hook into a 2 or 3 pounder, you never know. You don't have to worry about the gauge opening up and stuff. They've got them. This is 1/8 ounce. I got them in pink. I got them in white, pink, chartreuse, and white. That's all I need right here, right now, in late April to catch some crappies. This is my setup right here. Very light slip float. Look at that thing, just slides. And I got the float bobber stop here about 5 feet. One split shot to help bring the bait down quicker so the float sits more vertical, not horizontal. on the money end, right there, the Northern Tackle Supply little jig, little white chartreuse crappie magnet, and of course, that right there, the slab bite, been helping me catch crappie when the water is like 43 degrees and they really do not want to be aggressive, but I'm provoking them. They're coming up, smelling it, eating it. Let's get back to the action, catch some more crappies to inspire you. Come to Ontario, catch our beautiful black crappie. Let's go. Whoa, boy, oh boy. Look at my rod bend, dude. Look at my rod bend. Big slab, just nice slab. Look at these rods, man, wow, look at how that thing goes. Tell me that's not fun. Oh yeah, eater, eater. I love these ultralights, man. They just like feel like it's a monster. Oh my goodness, those hooks are just priceless. Crappie fishing, no matter what it is, good jigs are worth every single penny. Oh yeah, good eating size fish. Jigs are worth every single penny, the good stuff. I showed it to you, I'll show you again, but I mean, do not skimp on anything. I know it's crappie fishing. You don't have to use $15 jigs or minnow baits and spinner baits and things like that, but good jigs worth every cent when you get the crappie of the day, like this next one. Let's see, they're getting bigger. Sun's coming out, things are happening. The rod makes the fish look like they're 3 pounds. Just stopped, and I set, and there he was. Like there. And a better one. You wanna go this way? That's better right there. That's what I was talking about right there. About 12 inch plus. Look. The whole chain of command. The right rod, crappie magnet, and definitely slab bites are helping me on a rainy, cool spring day getting the feed of crappie. Love it. In the box you go, little boy. In the box you go. Just had to slow down. This is the honest time. 2 hours of looking for weed beds. I went to history spots. You know what those are? Places where you caught fish when you want to catch them again, and they're not there. You gotta discover, search, look for similar spots. Sometimes fish move, the weeds die off. It's different factors. But if you know that people have been catching fish the last few weeks and stuff, temperatures rise and they drop and you got snow. It is Northern Ontario. Just be versatile, look around. It's not a science. You just break down things about where to find them. When the water temperature is cold like that, keep altering your float, find those deep weeds. And when the sun gets up, the temperatures rise, you know they're gonna head towards the shallows again. But until they do that, we'll keep doing this to try to keep catching fish and have a fish fry. Here's important, I got my marker boy marking the specific area that I'm fishing, this deep weed bed. So I use that just as a reference, I don't just stay by it. But to my right, it was 12 feet going up to the rock shoal. The left-hand side, 7.5, 9 feet, all tapering, different holes and stuff, but the weed was higher or lower, it was different. And I found that by casting to the left, right to the center, I'm gonna call that 12 o'clock, this here was 9 o'clock, 3 o'clock, just altering the position of the weed bed. The crappie move based on the wind, the rain. We had all kinds of different barometer changes and stuff, and they just move around. It could have been from the bait fish, it doesn't matter, they just moved in the weed. So I dissected the whole weed bed. Use your marker buoys as a reference spot, your sonar, but if you got the power poles or the micros or an anchor, anchor in different spots, dissect and dominate those weed beds, and you'll catch those crappie as well. I saw you. You laid it down. You laid it down. I saw you. And yeah, you're coming for dinner. It seems like those nicer crappies are laying it down. and just holding on to it, not grabbing and running. You're not grabbing and running, are you? Nope, you're just holding it. Oh my God, I love those jigs. Just the right size for a couple of fillets, that's all. A couple, let's put it back out in the same spot. Now I've got my power poles down. I found a spot that's about 8.5 feet deep in this weed. So I put the poles down. So instead of staying on the trolling motor, I could do that. When the wind's pushing me like this, I'd rather just cast in front of the boat, not let the fish know I'm here, and hopefully just pluck a few right in front of me. All they see is that little bait there. They decide to just munch it. They're just grabbing it and laying down that float. The float's like vertical like this, and it just goes boop, and sits and stops. They're just holding it. They're not going anywhere. Some will take it and run, and your float will go. But some, it just stops. Slow, methodical for catching crappies. Whoa. Is that a crappie? Oh, nice one, dude. Oh, that's what we're fishing for right there. Get him, in the meat. Oh, I got him in the meat. That's what, oh, you see how dangerous that is? You see how dangerous it is? You can have the best hooks in the world, but when you get him in that membrane, oh boy, it can be dangerous. Right there, man, are they ever cold. Look how yellow they are. You know where he's sitting. Put him in the box, boys. Slowly but surely, working on dinner. But 1-2 punch, you've heard it before. I'm gonna say it again. Slab bite. It's like putting on a little piece of bacon on a sandwich. You know? You have a BLT. What's a BLT without the bacon? Boring. BLT, man, it's the bacon. In this case, slab bite. Let's see if we can do it again. That one, hit it, the shock, and then laid it down. That's what you like. You know those good 12 inches are in here. You gotta go through the smaller ones. Oh well. Catching crappie. I saw you. Good one too. Oh boy, he laid that down. I love when they do that, man. I know. Because if you ain't paying attention, you're gonna miss those bites. Look at that. Man, he's just barely in the membrane too. Barely. Look at this. Look at it. Easy crappie. Look where he is. He got lucky right there. Look at that. A little bit of hard stuff. Look where easy it pops out. Oh boy. That's a handful right there. That's what I call a crappie dinner in a good way. What y'all having for dinner? Oh, it's just another crappie dinner. In this case, it's a real fun dinner. So basically all this is like clumps, dudes. And there's black holes in the clumps between the thick weed coming up like a tree, like right there. And as it goes by, those crappie are sitting about, I would say, 3 or 4 inches below in those black holes you can't see between the thick weed. And when as that bait just drifts by with the wind, and I twitch it and stuff, just now covering water, and drifts by in front of their nose, they just decide to just, boop. That's why it's so important to have the right depth. I've shortened it a little bit, okay? So now it's about here. I've had it before up to here, and I'm getting a few more bites. So maybe they're a little bit higher in the weed. And if the bites stop, I'll lower it again to get down inside. But that was a couple bites in a row, two that definitely were crappy. It went up and then down. So he popped it. Yep, good one too. Laid it down. Oh, I think he's a fryer. He laid it down again. Boy, oh boy, you guys are eating it so slow, you won't even show me. Eh? Waiting for that float to go down is a big mistake sometimes. Look at the hook pop out. Oh boy, yeah. Fryer time. Let's put it back out. There's the marker, the far side of the weed bed. dominating. Finding, dominating. Love it. Love how they don't play around when you find them. Whoa. Look at this. Everything is in this area here, dude. Oh, good crappie, too. Look at this. Oh, just eaters. So honest to God, just perfect eaters. We all love to catch big fish. Trust me, I love catching big fat slabs. But when I can catch them like this to eat, I am in crappie heaven, boys. Just good eaters. Oh, nice. Boom, 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 boom. Let's put it right back out again. Right back on the edge here. Where are we? I don't even have a slab bite on. This is much confidence I'm getting now. I don't even have a slab bite on. I'm gonna put it back out. Whoa. There's my marker boy again, reference. You would have no idea where that weed bed is other than your GPS, but specifically knowing how to dissect the whole weed bed by having a reference point. It's so important. I can't stress how important that is. There, uh-oh. I think what we asked for, yep. Yay! Man, oh man. Incredible when you start catching fish, how you feel. Now we're catching some crappies, eating size fish. Love it. But I know where they are. They're on the tip of that weed bed right there. That's about the edge of the weeds right there. Oh yeah, oh boy, look at, I love when that rod bends, look at that. I love when that rod bends, dude. Look at that. What a scrapper. He's not even a giant, but he's got some beautiful girth to him. Look at him. Thick, solid crappie. Whew. Be able to cull out some of those small ones, dude, with some real eaters. That's it right there. Going in there. So, catching black crappies, late April, where the first 2 hours I thought maybe it would be, I don't know, search and destroy, 2 days to find them. We searched, moved around, white chartreuse crappie magnet, white, northern jig head, deadly. Slip float, and the new TCB series, Island Lures and B&M, is getting the job done. It's incredible with this wind. You get the bowl in the line, and you have to just, the pros and cons of it. You want that bait flowing, okay, you want flowing over the weed beds, over those pockets. So you want that float to sit upright, so you have to give it a bit of slack. But by doing that, you have the slack in the line too, okay? You gotta pick up that slack sometimes, and it's just the way it goes. But it's nice with these little reels, they pick up that slack, so you can make the cast. What I do is I pick up the line, bring it down like this. It helps a bit. So I'm watching the float, it hits the bobber stop, the float goes vertical. So anything happens, especially if it lays down, and the way these crappie have been biting, it's just like, it's going, and all of a sudden it's just like electricity, doop, and then it goes down. Go sideways. It's incredible. So subtle because of the cold water. But the whole combination, the rods, sensitivity, the persistence would help you catch those crappie when the water's cold. We need a couple good ones, man, in a row. Every year you catch. Just some nice big silver and green, beautiful crappies. That one. Oh boy. Is that almost a netter? Oh, it is, Carl. It is. It is. Stay on, boy. Stay on, boy. Stay on. Oh boy. Yes, sir. Carl gets a picture fish. Carl gets a picture crappie. That's it right there. That's what I'm looking for right there. There's the picture fish with the slab, with the crappie magnet right there. There's our picture, right there. It's a female. I'll show you, I will let her go. But that's it right there. 14 inch, beautiful, black and gold. Look at the belly. It's gonna be spawning soon, going shallow. But for now, catch a nice big one, net it, take some pictures, and we'll let her go. Look at that, eh? Aren't they gorgeous fish? Love the crappies, man. Love them. Go on, boy. See your friends for a bit. Dwarf those eaters. But that's the deal.
So we've caught them in back bays. We've caught them in sloughs with single pole. We've caught them on weed beds, on main lake, little cuts and coves and things like that. And now, one more little key, and it is about fishing main lake basin. If there's not a lot of weeds on the lake, those crappie just gang up. You know they do. There's ways you can catch them in the wintertime, but if it's exceptionally cold spring, they don't move in real tight. They stay in that 20, 25, 26, 27 foot of water. There's ways to catch them. On this next segment, you'll see just how big and how nasty the big black crappie are when you pick up a single little jig head. Okay, these are Northern Tackle Supply, with a little crappie magnet in bright Kelly green with a chartreuse tail, and you just fish it methodically. Use electronics, find them, catch them, destroy them. But hey, it's just like we did in this segment here. You have to respect those big females. They're getting ready to do their business. They're not ready to go shallow yet. The water temperatures are really cold. There's not a lot of weed and things. So I still want to catch fish. I was out with my buddy Josh McKay. We decided to stay out, find the main lake basin, work those fish vertically right above them. You won't believe the size of the crappie that were ganged up. I mean, it looked like the simulator was on the sonar, but we just stayed above them, moved around a little bit in different areas where they moved, you know, whether they got spooked and you catch a few fish and let them go. But we had a blast. We got some good fish to eat, let the big females go. But man, oh man, when you can find those big deep lake basin fish and they're ganged up like they were in winter before they go shallow, it could be lights out, some of the best and biggest crappie fishing of the entire year, or maybe even your life. Watch this.
It was -1 this morning, man. Ice all over the boat, trailer, you name it. Rod lockers are frozen, but that's what it takes sometimes to go out and have some fun. You know, early bird catches the crappie. That's a deal for us today. And today I got to hook up with a buddy who owns a Northern Tackle Supply, custom jigs, really good stuff, Josh McKay. And he said the water's still like in the mid-40s and stuff. And we all know those crappie just pull out from those shallows. So we're gonna try some main lake bass and vertical jigging below the boat, utilize our sonars, stay on the fish right above them with the trolling motor, and just fish, have some fun. We're fishing crappie deep, 21 feet below the boat. They ain't near the shallows now, yet. They probably will be. Now the sun gets up, but for now, this is how to catch them. Almost like walleye fishing. And we're lucky up here in the north because we do that a lot. And man, it makes you a way better fisherman, even for those big crappie. A lot of guys figure, you know, they're not on yet, but they'll bite. You just gotta get it in front of their nose. So we'll pick up some sensitive B&M poles, some crappie magnets, and hey, maybe you have to put some slab bites on again just to inspire them to look at it and then eat it. You're right, this reminds you so much of walleye fishing. Deep jigging, slow, methodical until it goes dunk. Come on, crappie. Sure, that drag set. So they've got some King Kong crappies in here, huh?
You bet.
So we're gonna get up, a little trek, find some backwater, it's a little bit warmer, get out a bit, main lake basin, and see if those crappie wanna cooperate for us and for you. Sit back, relax, we're about to hopefully have some fun with some big Ontario black giants. Let's see. We're gonna try some main lake basin big black slabs. Buddy Josh has got some areas that he's been catching them when the sun has been hot, the fish moved up, but now it's cold. That's Northern Ontario. those cold nights and stuff, the fishes pull out. A lot of guys go home early. We decided to fish the areas where those crappie go when they get out of the shallows. You've seen different shows and stuff, I'd fish deep weed, but the lake we're fishing doesn't have a lot of deep weed this time of year. So the secondary thing we're going to do is just fish like mud bottoms, but it's the main lake areas where they can just go and chill. And you can catch them too. Picked up a single pole, but a different way. Crappie spinning rod, Buck's graphite bean end, 6 pound test, and different jigs, Josh's jigs, Northern Tackle Supply. So I've got 5/32, 3/16, and 1/8. Mm-hmm. We're going to get down on top of the crappie, jig back and forth with slab magnets. And Josh had a few bites, you know, just striking at it. So maybe we'll go down to the crappie magnet, put on some little slab bites, catch some King Kong crappie. All right, here's what we changed up to. 5/32 crappie magnet, double green, okay? Little slab bite in the bottom. See them on the sonar? Let's see if that makes a difference between short strikers. Aye, aye, aye. And catching some of these King Kong crappie. Whew. Definitely fish down there, dude. Make sure I'm right on bottom. Lift up a little bit. Shake and bake. Look at those buggers, eh? I'm just going to back up a little bit on them,
yeah,
right?
For sure.
See them? This is when the editor says, I can't see anything. Show us.
Boom. Right on that for you, Carl.
Let's see. Oh, a starter. Josh knows his lake, right? Whenever he goes for the net. But it's a starter. We've seen him on the sonar, bunch on the bottom, something like 7 feet down, but a starter. That's a female too, look at her.
Yeah, belly on her, eh?
Hey?
Yeah.
Wow. We'll let you go. A beautiful color. Perry sound, crappie. One little boy, little girl. That was the ticket so far, Josh. Changed it up. You're saying, but oh, look at all the fish. Oh, my goodness.
That one's coming for you. You just went right through
the
water. See that?
That fish I got was one of the ones that were higher.
Yeah. That's what we were doing with the binoculars. All they would drive around, scan, and see them, and boom.
Wow.
One after the other. One's coming up for you, though.
Yeah. They're crazy, aren't they?
Yeah. Oh, here they go. Now we got the school going.
It kind of even affects the sonar. It bounces it. There's so much disturbance there.
Whoa. There's one.
Good one?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Josh. Netter, huh?
Not a bad one.
Oh. Oh. King Kong. Wow, dude. First boxer. Oh, my goodness, dude. Yeah, that's...
Nice. And whoa, look, Josh. Where's that crappie magnet?
Wow.
It's gone.
Close up of that. Let him zoom in on it, Josh. Wow, dude. That's a big crappie.
A nice, gorgeous fish here.
Yeah, man. You like the double green, too, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Almost matches your logo.
There we go. Beautiful.
Okay, man.
One for the box,
right? One for the box. What we're going to use is the Buck's Graphite crappie spinning rods, the 6-footers. They're a little combination. They just come in a small little reel, you know. You can buy them in all the big box stores across the United States, BM100s. And I got it with 8 pound braid going to a 5 pound Gamma Touch fluorocarbon leader on the money end, Northern Tackle Supply, which actually Josh actually custom pours them, that nice little green, Kelly green with chartreuse tail with a slab bite. So we're gonna find some crappie, utilize the sonar, get out, we see the fish, stop, vertically fish like we do for walleyes. Small one again.
Oh, almost a
I'm
dub.
I'm weeding out the little females for you. Oh, look what she spit out there, floating there, Josh.
Ah.
Slab bite, that's yours. I'm getting the small ones out of the way for you.
Perfect.
Little slab bites. Uh-oh. They are working, dude, huh? Cold water crappie. Deep, too? Boy. It goes to show you, they can be caught. It's almost like ice fishing, Josh, isn't it?
Identical. Just like it.
Seen them on a
just
sonar?
Just a bit warmer.
Yeah. And not sitting in a hut.
No. Enjoying the lake again. I enjoy it out here.
Let's see if we can catch more fish. Vertical jigging. I love the float fishing, but this is magical too, isn't it?
Yeah, it's fun.
It's fun, man. Playing that game with them. Watch them on the sonar.
Reminds you of a kid playing video games.
Yes. Oh, got tapped already. Man, are they ever light bite. I'm going to go through all the small ones, dude.
Gee.
Look. You know on some lakes that's keeper?
Really?
I don't fish those lakes anymore.
Oh, wow. No.
Just like, really? What, 8-inch crappies?
Gee.
No. Oh. States, they got 10-inch limits sometimes, Josh, because heavily fished.
Yeah, but control the population, right?
Yeah, control the population, and, you know, they get X amount. I don't know what the limit is. You got a meal, you know? But we're after King Kongs.
That's a little guy for here.
Same thing?
Yeah.
All right. The big girls are there, too.
Yeah, little guy.
Keep going.
See you later, sweetheart.
Do you believe it? Do you believe it? I was impressed with the first fish. This next one was just like mammoth, Goliath. You know, I'm thinking, what is it? Smallmouth? Rock bass? World record rock bass? Huge, big, black crappie that fills the net. I can already see King Kong climbing the mountain coming to us. Look at those. There's a couple there. Come on, crappie. Hold it up there. Look at the ones down there. My goodness.
Ooh. There we go.
Good one?
Yeah.
Oh, Josh. Oh, atta boy, Josh.
Beautiful.
He knows the King Kong crappie on his lake. Oh, my goodness. You should see this screen, dude.
Got a nice, beautiful
crappie. Beautiful fish, Josh.
Slamming these things. Boom. Once again, another female. Look at the size of the belly on these guys.
Yeah.
Wow.
We'll take pictures and let them go.
Little egg wagons right here.
All right, what sizes? You know, the wind's not really blowing very hard yet, but it's supposed to. So we've got a couple options with the crappie spinning rods, okay? So the 6-footers, we got the BM Pro 100s as well, and that's got 6-pound monofilament. And on the one rod, rigged up, 1/8 ounce, smaller profile, slab bite. And when the wind picks up a little bit, it gets breezy, we want to fish directly right below the boat like you're fishing for walleye, the 5/32. 1-2 combo, be prepared. We're going to catch more crappie. I can't get over it. It's like when I first time went to Mississippi and I started seeing those 2.5-pound whites. It's like hubcaps.
These guys
God.
Are on bite right
get
here.
Get ready. This is psychotic. Double. Yours is a netter, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is it?
Ah, I'll flip them.
Oh, look what I got.
Another nice crappie.
Mine was a...
Oh, a perch.
I'm catching everything except the hogs, eh? Go on.
Yeah, look at these. Look at the little bellies on these guys.
All females.
Goldies. Eh? Put that one in the well, I guess, for eating.
Sure,
here.
Sure.
Just gorgeous fish.
Josh is on the big fish bite. Got some kings there. I'd say. I can't even imagine when these fish go shallow what it must be like, Josh.
Oh, it's an absolute blast. Absolute riot.
That big like that? Or even single pole with a 10-foot pole? Oh my goodness. What happened there?
Stacked like cordwood again.
Oof.
He's got to get him to snap at us here a bit more. There we go. Oh, I lost him.
Okay, color options. Josh said he loves the green, but with crappie magnet, they make so many options, okay? So the Kelly green, I call it, with the chartreuse, you can't beat it. And see the common theme? Green, 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 green. This one has almost like a green with a refrigerator white. Solid chartreuse,
black chartreuse with a little bit of silver flake and the therapist. These colors right here, we're not going to divulge too much from variety. And whatever seems to be catching fish, and so far Josh has proven that the bright Kelly green with the chartreuse is kicking butt of all the other colors. But have variety, be prepared, because you never know what the crappie want on the lakes you fish. Let's catch some more crappies. Down to the abyss. Boy, for a minute there we had them just coming right up.
There we go.
Good?
Yeah.
Uh-oh, hear that? He says that?
That's a big crap.
Oh my good, are you kidding? Dude. I'm going to fall out of the boat. I'm just... Dude, that's not a big crappie. That is a giant.
Certified meat wagons, boys.
Dude.
Look at these suckers.
That's Mississippi style right there, eh?
Oh, there you go.
That is. We're not in Mississippi either. This is Northern Ontario, Parry Sound. Dude, that is a monster. Monster.
Just gorgeous fish.
You just made my spring right there, Josh.
Ah, no problem, man.
You weren't kidding.
No, I don't lie.
Dude, that is sick, sick. I've seen some big ones in the States. That's comparable. Hold them sideways for him, Josh.
That big old sucker. The size of the yappers. I'll send this girl home after.
Options for rods. Crappie spinning rod been doing the job, but we have another one. That's the B&M sharpshooter. You say, isn't that for docks and things like that? But this pole, seriously, 6.5 feet, 6 feet, one piece, perfect construction. Okay, see the blank to the handle? So we're fishing for these crappies too. Okay, we just have your finger here or here. You don't have to have it back in here on the reel, any which way that's comfortable, but they utilize that graphite through the handle for that sensitivity. So I like to hold it like this, because sometimes you don't even see your line jump, nothing happens. The only thing that happens is you feel that little electricity through the blank in the handle. So we got different options. Again, same jigs, line, everything's the same, because these fish seem to be in love with the green. There's one.
No net.
No net. I recognize the size, Josh. Somewhat like earlier today, but it's a good sign we're getting back on some fish, huh?
Heck yeah.
That's one. That's a good one?
Yeah.
It looks like it. Where's that?
I don't think it's a crappie, though.
No?
No. Oh, yeah, it is.
It is.
That's a crappie. There you are. Right on, boy. That's a beauty. That's gorgeous fish.
Yeah, man.
Slamming that.
Oh, I just missed one, dude. I just missed one.
That's beautiful. Spitting up that nice, beautiful.
Well, there you have it. Another episode from the Xtreme Angler Catching Crappie. There's no real big clues to catching spring crappie, but why wait until the temperature's in their 60s and go into sloughs and stuff that everybody knows, bumping boats, you're playing bumper cars and stuff. You don't have to wait, man. As soon as the ice comes off, explore, fish safe, find those little sloughs, as long as they're not private, you're not trespassing, you're not intruding on anybody else's property. They are there, the back of bays, I mean all the way to the back, man. Do not leave any stone unturned. The last 2 feet of a slough, the back of a bay, the shallowest water. If there's dark weeds on the bottom, if there's wood and a rock and stuff, it holds heat. Those crappie will find it. And if they're not in the shallow stuff you like, look out again like you saw in that segment. Go out to the deep main lake basin, because they're there. If the lake has crappie, they're waiting for you. So you can use either the bigger baits like the slab magnet, the smaller bait, the crappie magnet,
suspend them under floats, single pole them, or vertically jig them, because they're waiting in spring for you to be caught, even the water is ice cold. Just remember, fish safe, fish with a few buddies, you know, don't take chances, no fish is really worth it. We appreciate watching our channel. Hopefully you'll subscribe, and we'll see you next time for more hardcore crappie tips to help you catch more and bigger crappie. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. If you have any comments, look below in the description, put your comments, and yours truly will answer every question that you have, or statement, inquiry, whatever it is, man. I'm here for you to help you catch more and bigger crappie. Thanks for watching.